Hey, salute G's, Coach Davis back with another fucking video, and in this video I will be discussing semen retention and memories. You feel me? Salute all my new G's, my day one G's, and I do want to mention that, you know, I want to take the time out to say I do genuinely love everybody on my channel, everybody I inspire, everybody that's choosing to move right. You feel me? I hope this video helps y'all along y'all journey, y'all marathon of prosperity. You feel me? I also mentioned in another video, but I'm going to say it again. If you want to talk to me direct, I have a WhatsApp group chat. The link is in my description. Join the group chat. And if you need direct motivation from the motherfucking wolf himself, Coach Davis, then talk to me, G. Make you a WhatsApp and join the motherfucking chat. You are more than welcome to come along with me and my other motherfucking wolves that's running the chat with me. You feel me? So y'all enjoy the content. Salute to all my new G's, my day one G's. Y'all stay safe out here, you heard? Salute. So life in general, you gotta understand that memories don't never die. You will always remember, you know, interactions that you had with certain women. You will always remember videos that you was entertaining on porn and porn. Get some of your favorite porn stars. Those memories will most likely never die. Especially if they've had a great influence on you and you've been entertaining it for a while. I still deal with those thoughts to this day. But it's about what you do with those thoughts. Do you entertain them? Do you feed into them? Do you make them stronger? Right? Because at that point, you have to hold yourself accountable for that. There are people out here that are having a lot of wet dreams. And I hope that they're not lying and trying to use a wet dream as a way to admit that they relapsed in a way that people won't judge them. That's some sucker-ass shit, just to let you know. But more people gonna do what the fuck they wanna do. You feel me? So it is what it is. But at the end of the day, to stop lusting and to stop having wet dreams with, you know, those thoughts becoming more powerful in your subconscious mind, then it's about what you do with those thoughts. Do you like have counter thoughts? Why do you feed into them if you know that it ain't right? Why do you feed into them if you understand female nature and the red pill? Now at this point, you're just choosing to be dumb. There's no reason for you to be feeding into those thoughts. You have to just understand that your male nature will never change. You will always love women. You always may be lustful women. But at the end of the day, it's about the choice that you make after those thoughts. What are you doing after that? Are you working out? Are you then choosing to take that sexual energy that comes from that sexual thought and using it to have a positive thought, something that means more to you, something that you actually really want, something that will give you longevity in your life? Why are you listening to a bunch of drill music and a bunch of low vibrational motherfuckers talking about bullshit all day and then mad when that stuff has an effect on your being? You feel me? Rather than listening to an affirmational video. I listen to an affirmational video every day. A video that talks about health, wealth, and abundance. A bunch of I am healthy, I am wealthy, I am rich, I am powerful beyond measure. And then what I do with those subconscious thoughts and those I am affirmations that video gives me, I then build my own I am affirmations, and then I will constantly repeat them shits in my mind all day. Especially when I'm having a negative thought, especially when I'm having a nasty ass lustful thought. So make sure you keep that in mind as well, G's. So you can't knock your body for wanting to do something that you've been training your body to do for years. Now it is your responsibility to now train your body to not do it. It's about how bad do you want it. You cannot expect shit to be easy and fit to just change with the snap of a motherfucking finger. Life don't work like that. This is a process. Learn and grow. Don't never beat yourself up. Learn and grow. Learn about your nature. Wow, these thoughts keep coming. It's like I can't seem to stop them from happening. Well, maybe it's because you've been feeding into those thoughts for years. It's okay. Relax. It's okay. Now, what are you gonna do about it? Are you gonna now train your mind to tell your body that that is not okay to release that fluid, and it is not okay to have these thoughts. Or when we do have these thoughts, because we will always love women, what are we gonna do with these thoughts? Are we gonna now have a counterattack? If somebody swing on you, you feel me? Are you just gonna let them punch you in your motherfucking face and be doing this to your fucking mouth like a bitch ass nigga crying? Or you gonna weave that motherfucker and hit him in his shit? That's how life is. It's about your counterattack. Your next move gotta be your best move. If your first move wasn't good, that is preparation for that next move. That's all this is, G. Don't fucking beat yourself up for that shit. Memories don't never die, man. They don't. You feel me? I love y'all, man. For real, I ain't even take a shower yet. You feel me? I was just in my group chat having a good conversation with my G's, and they just gave me the idea to speak on this, because one of the G's was talking about he had a wet dream. I felt a little guilty about having the thoughts he was having, so now I'm taking the time out to motivate him along with everybody else that could relate to him, because you are not alone. You're not alone. That's why I got the group chat. And I'm thorough in my group chat, just like on this fucking YouTube shit. I don't give a fuck about subscribers. I'm not Hollywood. I'm here for the people. That's it. I'm here for the people. I'm here for y'all. Because I want everybody to win. You know why most people ain't going to move how I'm moving and be so thorough and be so raw how I am? It's because they don't want to block their blessings. They fucking stupid. Whatever's meant for you is meant for you, and nobody can take that away from you. So don't try to hold back and be some Hollywood motherfucker because you're afraid to give somebody else game to help them. So you keeping it for yourself because you're afraid that, what? If you exist, keep your fucking ass away from me, bro, because I can see right through motherfuckers like you. That's not cool, man. Anything I know, any game I got, I give it away. My baby moms, like I said before, left me, and her, one of her things she said was she left, this is 2 years ago, so I ain't even mad no more or nothing, but I was in a moment. She said that I was just a guy that was just her teacher so that she could move on with her life. That's how much game I was giving her. She left me and felt like she ain't even need me no more. And I'm never going to change still. Still. I'ma always be this way. Even if my next girl do the same thing. Even if my next girl do the same thing. Even if my wife of 10 years do the same thing. Even if my homie of 10 years do the same thing. I've done my job if you feel like you don't need me no more. I'm not gonna give you just enough so that you could stay with me. Or I'm not gonna keep you in fear so that you fear leaving me or fear not being around me. If you feel like you don't need me, I wish you the motherfucking best, and I love you still. Now back to the motherfucking topic at hand. Memories don't never die, especially memories that you've been feeding into for years, especially things that you've been doing for years. But what are you gonna do right now? After this video, what are you gonna do? You gonna listen to your favorite drill rapper talking about murdering and killing and fucking bitches? Or are you gonna go search up an affirmational video? Or are you gonna go search up a fucking meditation video and get your thoughts right and start reprogramming your brain? Are you gonna put in the footwork? I hope so. I'm gonna end the video off like this. The battle is you versus you, man. It's you versus you. I've said this plenty of times before. It's you versus you. Hold yourself accountable, learn and grow. This is a marathon, not a sprint, so it's going to take time. You feel me? So just enjoy the ride. Don't be afraid to fail. You're gonna sin. You're not perfect. You will probably forever, for the rest of your life, lust over a woman. You could be walking outside chilling, and you see a woman with thick thighs and thick ass and beautiful. Of course you're gonna desire that woman. Of course you're gonna favor her. Because that is your subconscious letting you know that she is fertile. That's what I believe thick thighs resemble. Thick thighs and thick waist resembles a woman that is very fertile. Of course we will favor those women, just like the women will favor us because we are on semen retention with all of this valuable semen, this testosterone, this pheromone. They will always favor us. So don't beat yourself up for that. This is just life, G. Y'all enjoy the rest of y'all motherfucking day. Y'all stay safe out here and stay the fuck out of your feelings. And don't fear nothing, especially if you believe in the Most High. You feel me? And the marathon continues. Salute.